Hello everybody, my name is Leo and with this video we'll share a direct comparison between the Boss GT1000 versus the Edrush pedalboard. First of all, we will share a demo song hearing the two units in action, then we will compare the feature and technical characteristics of the two units with a very detailed comparison chart, then we will hear more sounds, also comparing the two units with real tube amps, and finally I will give you my 2 cents. So I hope you enjoyed and please subscribe and hit the bell. It's gonna help me to make more videos like this. Let's start with the demo song. Now check the differences between the two units among the following parameters: number of amps, caps and microphones built in, number of bank, patches and presets, number of effects, MIDI possibility, audio in and outs, foot switches and expression pedals, screen size, looper capabilities, ADA conversion and USB capabilities, special features, current power, dimension, weight and price. First of all, we have 23 amps and caps plus 12 standalone caps and 5 mix built in the GT1000, while the Edrush offers 44 amps and 15 caps and 10 mix. Both the units offer the possibility to load third-party IRs. Therefore, I will give a thumbs up to the Edrush as it offers more amps. It is worth noticing that the so-called ARD amplifier design philosophy of the Boss put an emphasis on accurately recreating the interaction between a total amplifier setup, amp plus speaker section. As such, each amp model is recreated with its ideal speaker combination. That's why here I'm writing 23 amps and caps plus 12 more caps, because the 23 amps and caps have been captured together with the ARD Boss technology. Furthermore, the Boss have 2 sets of 50 banks, each of 5 patches, with a total amount of 500 patches, 250 for the user and 250 built-in. The Edrush, on the other hand, has 270 presets or rigs, therefore the Boss is the winner here. As regards effects, the Boss has more than 116 effects, while the Edrush has 54 effects. For both of them, you can use many effects simultaneously. I would say that the limit is your imagination. destination and, well, the DSP power. In this case, I would give a thumbs up to the Boss as it offers more effects. Both have the same MIDI capabilities, then we have almost the same possibilities as regard input and outputs. With a mono instrument input, a stereo output both balanced and unbalanced, two in and out for external effects, and finally an headphone out. Dead Rush has the aux in that the Boss is missing. The Boss has 10 foot switches and a built-in expression pedal, while the Dead Rush has 12 foot switches, still with a built-in expression pedal. The Boss has one more input for external switches or expression pedal and an amp control out. So I would say that they are on par, as the Dead Rush has more foot switches, but the Boss has more connectivity option for external controllers. The screen size of the Dead Rush is way better, no doubt here. As regards the looper, the GT1000 has 19 seconds stereo looper, while the Dead Rush has a 20 minutes looper, so the Dead Rush is better. In the comparison chart, you can also find the looper controls of the two units, and in my channel, I've also done a video about the GT1000 looper. As regards ADA conversion and USB capabilities, the Boss is better, with 32 bits converters at 96 kHz. Furthermore, the Boss offers a 6-in, 6-out USB audio interface, while the Dead Rush has 4-in and 4-out USB channels. As regards special features, I would mention the Bluetooth capabilities of the GT1000, with which you can edit your effect chain with your tablet, and this is pretty handy and nice. While among the Dead Rush special features, I would mention the possibility to configure the foot switches in 5 different modes, that are stomp mode, rig mode, hybrid mode, setlist mode, or song mode. For instance, in stomp mode, the middle 8 foot switches correspond to models, amp, caps, or effects. While in song mode, the 4 foot switches toward the right correspond to 4 rigs from a song in your setlist. So I would say that they are on par. As regards the power needs, the GT1000 needs 9 volts at 1200 mAh, while the Dead Rush has an internal PSU. So I would give a thumbs down to both of them, as it is difficult to use our normal pedal power adapters. As regards dimension and weight, the Boss is way smaller and lighter. Actually, the Dead Rush pedal ball is really big and heavy. And finally, the price is basically equal. Here, I would say that the price is too high for both the units, considering that both the units are available since many years. So finally, let's count the green and red thumbs. We have 7 green thumbs for the Boss with 6 reds, and 7 greens for the Dead Rush with 6 reds. So they are on par. Obviously, this is just a technical comparison, without considering that each feature could have a different importance for you. And so, for instance, you can consider the Boss better just because it has the Bluetooth option. Or, on the other hand, you can consider the Dead Rush better because it has 2 more foot switches. But if you just algebraically sum the features according to my comparison chart, they are on par. Thank you. Now, final consideration here. First of all, let me say that my opinion could be biased as I own the GT1000 since more than a year and Bose effects since many years, so I'm much more used to their sound. As it's quite difficult for me to choose one unit against the other, I would focus on the pro of each unit. I mean, the features that are really important for me. Of course, this is gonna be my personal opinion for my specific use cases, and you may not agree with me, and this is totally fine. As I said, I grew up using Bose effects, like reverb, delays and chorus. And I have to say that having all these Bose effects in the GT1000 package is really a pro. The second pro of the GT1000 is the Bluetooth connectivity and the possibility to control it via an app with your tablet, without the need of a computer. The third pro of the GT1000 versus the Edrush pedalboard is that the GT1000 is smaller and much lighter. On the other hand, the Edrush pedalboard has, first of all, a very intuitive touchscreen that is pretty easy to use. It also has a far superior looper, and finally, I would mention the possibility to configure the foot switches in 5 different ways. For instance, in stomp mode, rig mode, song mode, which is pretty handy. On the other hand, I would say that both the units share a negative point, which is their prices. It's too high in my opinion, also considering that they are out since many years and that the prices of their chip should have decreased. I would say that they should be priced like the Moore G300, around 700. But now I'm really curious to hear from you, your opinions. What are the most important selling points for you and which unit would you buy? The Bose GT1000 or the Edrush pedalboard? Is the sound difference between these two units a key deciding factor for you? Is their price fair? Please let me know in the comment below. Actually, I'm receiving a lot of comments in these type of videos, and I think that they all can help us to choose the right unit according to our needs. We have now reached the end of this video. I hope you enjoyed, and if you did it, please subscribe to my channel, hit the bell and leave a thumbs up. It would be of a great help. And of course, you won't miss my future video. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Bye bye.